There are two kinds of overlays in 3D-Album. The first kind applies to the entire album, which we will call the album overlay. You can use this kind of overlay to create an opening animation, album titles, or a persistent front overlay. The other kind of overlay is a photo overlay. This overlay appears and disappears with the associated photo. The 3D-Album album overlay feature can be found under the Overlay tab. Ensure you have the 3D Time animation library. There are four options offered in this tab. The back option is for background overlays and will appear behind the photos. The other three options appear above or in front of the main level photo animation. Far front appears closest to the photo and farthest from the viewer. Front appears closer, and near front is the overlay layer closest to the viewer. To add an overlay, click the Add button. This will open up a dialog containing the object library. A preview window to the right will allow you to see the overlays as you browse through the various overlays provided to the left. After selecting an object, you can click on the Property button to edit the object setting. When you click on the Property button, an Object Attributes dialog will appear. Under the preview window are four tabs. The first is the Property tab. Different objects will have different properties. The Location tab allows you to change the object's location, size, and angle. To change animation settings, click on the Animation tab. You can disable the keyframe animation by checking off the Enable Keyframe Animation option. Turn on the Loop option if you want the keyframe animation to be played in loop mode. The Start time is used to control the animation start time. Before the animation is started, the object is usually hidden. You can change your overlay by clicking the Change button and selecting a new overlay. To remove your overlay, just simply click the Remove button. The Pan Zoom tab of the Pan Zoom styles also offers a photo overlay option. This overlay option will only appear for the photo you select it for. The first overlay to the left will move along with the photo. Thus, the object contained in the overlay will move along with the pan and zoom animation of the photo, as if the object is embedded in the scene of the photo. Let's look at an example. Let me add this overlay to the right-hand side of the photo. Notice how the added overlay of balloons and gifts stay at the set location of the photo. When the pan and zoom animation moves out of that location, the overlay does not show. Another overlay, called animation, will be displayed for the same duration as the photo, but it will not move along with the photo like the previous overlay option. Instead, it will be fixed in the screen or follow its own animation path. This is suitable for overlays like photo titles. For this photo, let me add some text. Note that the text stays at the bottom left corner of the preview window and does not move along with that photo.